How many episodes a year does Sizzletown put out?
It's monthly now.
Monthly.
It was fortnightly, but we just couldn't keep it up. Mm. It's too much work. It's got more elaborate.
It's a brilliant universe. Will they ever make a film or a cartoon of Sizzletown, do you
think? It could be animated. It's tricky because if you haven't heard it, it's a talkback show where I play the host and all of the callers. Mm. So it's an audio version of stop-motion animation putting it together.
Because there's an amazing poster of all the characters as the way he imagined them.
That's right.
It must have been amazing to see that.
Well, this is a great cartoonist, Glenn Robinson, known as Grob, and he's just a fan of the show, and he started drawing the characters. And I decided, well, if he's going to do this, if he's going to lend his art in service of what we're doing, I'm not going to give him any instruction. I just want to see what comes out of his head. Mm. So it's fascinating to see how he pictures them. Obviously, some of the characters are real people. For example, I play William Friedkin, the director of The Exorcist, so he knows what he looks like.
Yeah.
But he has to imagine some of the others.
Yeah, there's a man who runs the comedy store out in Rosanna.
It's a politically incorrect venue called The Busted Nut. Called Dave Clacton.
There's a man who's always calling in who's worried about nanobots.
Well, this is interesting because this was a theory. I don't know much about the Illuminati, but am I right in saying that that was a theory that was invented as a joke?
70s one, yeah.
But then it took off. So we've had this happen with Sizzletown. In 2018, we had a character call in claiming that the government was putting nanobots into vaccines to control the populace. And now this has taken off. Like, there have been rallies in Melbourne for this very thing. I want to see how far we can take this because we've got heaps of conspiracy theories. We have a character who claims that if you watch every show on Netflix, you get to see a secret Netflix show. It's like the best ever Netflix show. It's like a combination of Making a Murderer, Tiger Bloke, and The Crown all mixed together. So that's clearly nonsense that's been made up. But I've had people say to me, Is that true if you watch every... Okay, how long would it take? You've got to watch every Selling Sunset, every Green Leaf, every Peaky Blinders. How long would it take to watch everything on Netflix? You'd have to have multiple televisions going at once.
Somebody out there's doing it, Tony, and they're going to be very mad at you.
Yeah, we have a conspiracy theorist who says, why is there only a 29th of February every 4 years? Mm. Clearly the government is hoarding 29th of February's, which they can deploy at any moment. You'll wake up one morning and there'll suddenly be a new Thursday. Yeah. This is just nonsense. But I'm hoping that these other theories will take off the way the nanobots one has.
I do love the character who's a right-wing, loves Tony Abbott.
He's called Simon Haight. He's the host of The Haight Report on. And he's just every episode he appears in, he will sing a love song to Tony Abbott.
Yeah, and one of my favourites, it could be from the Triple R world. He's very negative about this when he discovers the show's still on.
I just wanted a character who hates the show to call in. And I went, if you're going to do that, it has to be really savage. Like, you can't just have it be gentle.
Yes.
So I just take the nastiest things that people say about us on the internet and put them into his mouth. And it's quite brutally truthful.
Oh, no, not you again.
That's right. And he'll just slag off all my other work as well. Like, when I do the voices on the Logies, he'll go, is it meant to be funny? It's sort of not really one or the other, is it? It's sort of real, but it's kind of funny. You're not really hitting either of those posts.
Where do people access Sizzletown?
It's on wherever you get podcasts.
And you have amazing merch.
I had someone, a bigwig in the world of radio, call, who does all your merch? Mm. Who can we get, wanting to get a whole radio station's merch done by? And I said, it's done by Matt Dower out of his spare room in his house.
It's amazingly high production podcast because you can hear Tony's abilities with voice, but Matt is incredibly skilled in editing. And
we love sound effects and music and just all of the bells and whistles of audio that you generally don't hear in podcasting. Mm. Generally, it's three people sitting around crapping on. Yeah, I do one like that myself.
Badly recorded too, and a bad voices. But one of my favourites, of course, is when your cat calls in and
we use
you put it through the translator.
There was an episode recently where I had to go and move my car, so the cat hosted the show for about 5 minutes and was just...
That was awesome.
It was vendettas against other cats.
He hates birds.
He did a song. He did Wet Legs, Chaise Long, and... this has been the most popular thing we've ever done. In 60 episodes, people are going, the bit with the cat hosted, that should be the whole show.
The pathos when he calls up and asks what's for dinner.
The best things in the show are based on just real life. And so we would notice if we went out to have a pub meal, the cat would just be sitting there looking at us with this sad look. And we would always, just for our own amusement, do the voice of, I thought I was part of the family. When am I getting my own Palmer? We just do that in the car.
It's
and
so
then
cruel.
I remember saying, well, what if that was on the show? But how can a cat, how would a cat be able to call into a radio show? And then I think it took 8 episodes of me challenging Matt to build a cat translation machine, which, if you notice, is not very stable. So sometimes it turns into Pauline Hanson.
It's a bit like Doctor Who when he can't tell where the TARDIS is going to go.
That's right. And so we did that, and I remember thinking, this is too insane. Like, people are not going to go with this, and it is now the most popular thing in the show.